What up, guys? It's Sink, sitting here at White Map, and I'm going to be doing another classes on today. Now, remember when I said I was taking armor suggested and I made classes for them? This person suggested this armor, and I was already in the motion of making this class. It used to be one of my favorite armors back in 2012 and not. So, I decided to went ahead and make this class and get this out as fast as I can since I had so much love for this armor back then. This class is called Lightcaster. Now, let me pull up the class overview. It has a mage-based build with a mage-based mana regeneration, meaning it's a full-on caster. It does not have the healer build, mainly focusing on haste and endurance other than intellect, like the most healers do, like healer, archfiend, etc., etc. This one mainly focuses on intellect, and intellect only, which is like Dracomancer, the normal caster build, Darkblood Storm King, Troll Spellsmith, what's another good one? Mindbreaker. Those are some really good examples of the mage-based build that this class has. And how they gain mana, Lightcasters gain mana from all hits landed in combat, and especially on crits. The amount depends on the damage relative to the HP total. Basically what this means, the more health you have, the more mana you're going to get successfully hitting the opponent doing damage. So let's say if you have less health, like really low health, you won't get that successful mana regeneration to complement your skills and complement your mana pool. Alright guys, actually I'm going to read the description. Alright, the Order of Lightcasters formed to fight against darkness. With direct concentrated attacks, they are able to take down a foe with ease. Legion beware, Lightcasters do double damage to their sneaky undead foes. To reach their peak, they need sacrifice to attain victory. The end justifies the means. Basically what that means is the Lightcasters will do anything to take down to take down darkness or chaos or whatnot. And this skill, this is a whole skill complemented to take down undead. So every skill that this class has deals double damage to undead enemies. Alright guys, let's talk about the auto attack. Alright, it's called Soul Strike. A sacred strike improved by your intellect stat. Cooldown 2 seconds. A magical skill in the range is close. Basically, you've seen this on a lot of classes, but they don't really actually tell you. It just says basic attack taught to all adventurers. Besides on Chrono Dragon Knight and regular Dragon Knight Spellblade that have go off of magical damage. But some classes do go off of intellect stat for the auto attack. For casters, Darkblood Storm King, Bard does as well too. Those are two prime examples of classes that go off of their intellect stat. Check them out when you use the classes. Look how high their auto attack is. Sometimes the higher the intellect you have, the stronger the auto attack is. So just look at the auto attack on Darkblood Storm King or Bard, and you'll see that it's very stronger than 90% weapon damage, which is the regular mage class percentile. Alright guys, let's proceed on to the first skill. It's called Dawnrend. Summons the power of the first light onto the opponent, dealing moderate damage to the target. Applies visionless. Lowers the hit chance by 25% for 6 seconds. Deals bonus damage if the strike is first in combat. Mana 20, cooldown 8 seconds. It's a magical skill and the range is far. Basically, this class goes off of 3 skills and the 3 powerful rays that the Lightcaster has. This is the first ray called Dawn Ray. They all have the same mana cost, they all have the same cooldown, and they all have the same weapon damage. So this is 140% weapon damage, but it is 200% weapon damage if this is the first hit in combat. So you have to remember that, and also applies visionless, lowering the hit chance by 25% for 6 seconds. So it kind of has that tuning, paralyzing wind feel, just to give the lower hit chance and give it an overall defense to the class. Alright guys, let's proceed on to the second skill. It's called Solar Ray. Harness the power of the sun, scorch and die enemy, dealing moderate damage. Applies ignite, applying a moderate damage over time for 8 seconds, and raises the magical damage they receive by 15% for the duration. Mana 20, cooldown 8 seconds. It's a magical skill and the range is far. Like I said, this also does 140% weapon damage, but it comes with a very gruesome DOT as well, giving you extra damage to flow into the opponent. So this does a 150 to 200 damage over time, depending on spell power. So wherever your spell power is, it's going to be beyond in that somewhere in that category, depending on your spell power. It only ticks for 8 seconds, so that's only about... Well, it ticks about every 2 seconds maybe, so it's not going to be a lot of damage whatnot, but it's going to be that extra boost of magical damage on the opponent that they receive, boosting that DOT and all your other skills that are magical, which is everyone in the class. Alright guys, let's proceed on to the third skill, It's called Divine Rim. Sponsors Sacred Light, bestowed upon the target, dealing moderate damage, applies judgment, negating their chance to crit for 6 seconds. Mana 20, cooldown 8 seconds, it's a magical skill in the Ring's Fire. Basically, this is 140% weapon damage as well, but it negates their chance to crit for 6 seconds. Now, this does not negate every class chance to crit. Some classes have guaranteed crits like Alpha Omega, Arachnomancer, Warrior's Prepared Strike, Evolved Dark Castle, Soul Scourge. You just have to basically regular base attacks that are not guaranteed to crit will not be able to crit for this short amount of time. As you see, all the race skills, they're very low weapon damage. They don't really do a lot of damage. That's why you have the Intellect auto attack give you that main source of damage. So you have to come up to the opponent, hitting them a little bit, get that successful mana that you need to constantly use your skills. These rays are not really that powerful, but their debuffs and effects are powerful. It's what the main class is for. Alright guys, let me pull up the class review again. Hold on. Alright. The rank 4 passives. The first one is Light Through Yonder Poster Break. Everybody knows this from Shakespeare. Increases intellect and wisdom by 10%. You can't argue more intellect, increasing your auto attack and all your magical abilities. Also improving your haste by a short amount, since intellect mainly focuses on spell power and giving haste to caster classes. And the wisdom increases your hit chance, crit chance, and evasion chances, giving an overall spellbreaker feel to the class. Alright, and the second one is Radiant Cloak. Increases all heals by 25%. This class has a heal? Yes, it's coming up next at skill 5, so let's proceed on to it. Alright, and the last skill is called Sanctuary. Sacrifices one of your rays of light. By doing that, you increase your haste by 25%, cut your mana cost in half, and applies a moderate heal over time for 20 seconds. Apply skill lock, randomly locking one of your raid skills for the duration. Mana 60, cooldown 15 seconds, it's a magical skill and the range of status. Basically, this is your... Basically, what this means is what the class description says. The ends justifies all means. Remember, it said by reaching its peak, it sacrifices one of its abilities. Basically, this is what this means. So you sacrifice either Dawn Ray, Solar Ray, or Divine Ray to apply the Sanctuary, and the heal over time is 150 to 200, depending on spell power. Now, when you think about it, this is not a lot, but for 20 seconds, you're going to get a lot of heal over time in that short amount, so you just got to know how to stay away from your opponent, or know how to keep yourself alive with the debuff of the raid. Now, this randomly locks one of your raids, so you don't know which one you're going to lock. It depends on where you're facing. Like, maybe you don't want this to be locked or whatnot, so you just have to, it's basically a luck-based skill. You don't know which raid you're going to, lock, so... You just gotta hope for the best and see what's going on. By that, you get a really good buff, cutting your mana cost in half, raising your haste by 25%, and a moderate heal over time, all for 20 seconds. Now, when you think about it, these classes do have a little bit short cooldowns of 8 seconds. You're gonna be hitting these skills a lot faster than normally, and cutting the mana cost cut in half, so they're gonna be 10 mana. Think about that, guys. You're gonna have that old school mage feeling, but with more debuff and more meaning onto the opponent. So this is a really good skill. It is a really good overway to complement the class. And the skill is able to loop, but it will not lock the same raid twice in a row. So remember that, guys. Now, when you look at this class all together, what do you think of it? Do you think this is a really good class? I think I would use this class very well. Just for this, the point of using the rays of light to defeat all undead enemies and then the sanctuary... It just wraps up the class, makes it really nice, just wraps it in a bow tie with the increased heals buff and then another intellect buff on the rank 4 passes. It will make that heal over time and all your class and all your damage a little bit more stronger than usual, giving a little bit more haste, heal over time, and cutting your mana cost in half. Also, this class do has a rank 10 passive. It's called Holy Ray. The clouds disperse, giving a passage to a mighty light, dealing massive damage to the target. So this is basically one of those rare passives, not a perma passive, that does the massive damage onto the opponent. Keeping it old school, guys. So what do you guys think about this class? Will you actually use this class in AQ? Let me know in the comments what you think of it. Let me know in the comments what anything I should change or anything that you like. Or just, should it be the actual light caster armor? Should it be something different? Just let me know, guys. This basically sums up this video. Like and subscribe. Share with all your friends. I'm Sync. Catch you guys later. See ya. I am my father's son, cause he's a fan, so I'm a mystery, and that leaves me nothing. Many times, if you wanted to die, it's too late for me. All you had to do was get rid of me. You can't decide on what I'm